In this video, we will talk about bundle branch blocks. However, to comprehend the underlying mechanisms of deflections observed on ECG tracings in patients exhibiting bundle branch blocks, it is imperative to first establish a foundation of knowledge regarding the normal ventricular activation process. It is imperative to bear in mind that the depolarization wave moving towards the positive pole of a specific lead results in a positive deflection on the ECG trace, and vice versa. Normally, ventricular activation begins with ventricular septum depolarization, producing the R wave in lead V1 and the Q wave in lead V6. Subsequent to septal depolarization, the right and left ventricles undergo depolarization. Due to the significantly larger size of the left ventricle, the electrical vector directed towards it exceeds that of the right ventricle. This produces the deep S wave in lead V1 and the higher wave in lead V6. Bundle branch blocks produce wide QRS complexes, in other words, more than 120 milliseconds, with specific patterns in leads V1 and V6. In the case of the right bundle branch block, ventricular septal depolarization produces the R wave in lead V1 and the Q wave in lead V6. Due to the bundle branch block, the left ventricle undergoes an initial depolarization, resulting in the S wave in lead V1 and the R wave in lead V6. Subsequent to the occurrence of left ventricular depolarization, the impulse propagates through the myocardium to the right ventricle, thereby producing the R wave in lead V1 and a wide, slurred S wave in lead V6. The right bundle branch block results in an RSR pattern, M-shaped, in lead V1, frequently extending to leads V2 and V3, and a slurred S wave in lead V6, also, frequently in leads I, et al. MARROW serves as a mnemonic device for the RBBB. The letters M and W in the mnemonic correspond to a M-shaped QRS complex in lead V1 and a W-shaped complex in lead V6, respectively. Right bundle branch block is characterized by a RSR, M-shaped, pattern in leads V1, V2 and a wide slurred S wave in leads V5, V6. Additionally, the QRS complex width exceeds 120 milliseconds. The T-wave inversion in the right precordial leads and or downsloping or horizontal ST segment depression may be seen in leads V1, V3. If the QRS complex is M-shaped, RSR pattern, in lead V1, but the width of the QRS complex is less than 120 milliseconds, incomplete, also called partial, right bundle branch block is diagnosed. The rista supraventricularis pattern is similar to the incomplete right bundle branch block. However, in this case, the QRS complex width is less than 100 milliseconds, and the S wave width in lead V6 does not exceed 40 milliseconds. The underlying cause is attributed to delayed depolarization of the crista supraventricularis, a condition that manifests in healthy individuals. In left bundle branch block, the ventricular septum undergoes a process of depolarization from right to left. Under normal circumstances, the ventricular septum undergoes a process of depolarization from the left to the right, a process that is facilitated by the septal fascicle of the left bundle branch. A left bundle branch block results in the presence of a Q wave in lead V1 and an R wave in lead V6. As the left ventricle depolarization is delayed, the vector of depolarization is directed towards the right ventricle, producing small deflection in leads V1 and V6 directed to isoline. Then the left ventricle is depolarized. The depolarization wave exhibits a leftward movement, resulting in a substantial negative deflection in lead V1 and a positive deflection in lead V6. The left bundle branch block produces M-shaped complex in lead V6, and often in leads I, et al., V5. William is a mnemonic word for the left bundle branch block. The letters in this acronym correspond to specific characteristics of the electrocardiogram. ECG W signifies a W-shaped QRS complex in lead V1. L denotes a left bundle branch block, and M indicates an M-shaped complex in lead V6. Left bundle branch block is characterized by a wide QRS complex, in other words more than 120 milliseconds, wide monophasic often notched or wave in lead V6, also, often in leads I, et al., V5, dominant S wave in lead V1, absence of Q waves in the lateral leads. The SC segment is displaced in the opposite direction to the dominant wave of the QRS complex. The direction of the T wave is usually opposite to the dominant wave of the QRS complex. The left anterior fascicular block, also referred to as left anterior hemiblock, results in left axis deviation with typical range from minus 45 degrees to minus 90 degrees. The QRS complex width does not exceed 120 milliseconds. There is a prolonged R wave peak time in lead AVL, more than 45 milliseconds. QR complexes in leads I, AVL and RS complexes in leads 2, 3, AVF are seen. As the left fascicle is blocked, an electrical impulse spreads by the septal and posterior fascicles. The vector is directed downward and to the right, producing small Q waves in the lateral leads, I, AVL, and smaller waves in the inferior leads, 2, 3, and AVF. Then the impulse moves upward and to the left. The deep S wave in the inferior leads and the high R wave in the lateral leads are seen. The left anterior fascicular block causes prolongation of the QRS complex by approximately 20 milliseconds compared to the normal conduction. In most patients with left anterior fascicular block, the QRS complex width ranges from 100 to 120 milliseconds, but this doesn't significantly affect the cardiac output. This ECG shows RS pattern in leads 2, 3, AVF, QR pattern in leads I, AVL and R wave peak time in lead AVL is 60 milliseconds. There is QRS complex width of 110 milliseconds and left axis deviation. The left posterior fascicular block, also called left posterior hemi-block, causes the right axis deviation, more than plus 90 degrees. It's much less common than left posterior fascicular block. The QRS complex width doesn't exceed 120 milliseconds. There is prolonged R wave peak time in lead AVF, more than 45 milliseconds. QR complexes in leads 2, 3, AVF and RS complexes in leads I, and AVL are seen. As the posterior fascicle is blocked, an electrical impulse spreads by the septal and left fascicles. The vector is directed upward and to the left, producing smaller waves in the lateral leads, I, AVL, and small Q waves in the inferior leads, 2, 3, AVF. Then the impulse moves downward and to the right. The higher wave in the inferior leads and the deep S wave in the lateral leads are seen. The left posterior fascicular block is diagnosed only in the absence of other causes of the right axis deviation, such as right ventricular hypertrophy, lateral ST segment elevation, myocardial infarction, pulmonary embolus. There is RS pattern in leads I, AVL and QR pattern in leads 2, 3, AVF. There is right axis deviation. R wave peak time in lead AVF is 50 milliseconds. If the QRS complexes are wide, in other words more than 120 milliseconds, but there is a pattern of neither left nor right bundle branch block, a nonspecific intraventricular conduction delay is diagnosed. This ECG shows pattern of the left anterior fascicular block, but QRS complexes are 140 milliseconds in width. The combination of the right bundle branch block pattern with left axis deviation belongs to bifascicular blocks. In this case, both the right bundle branch and the anterior fascicle of the left bundle branch are blocked. At this ECG, right bundle branch block pattern is combined with left axis deviation. QRS complex width is 140 milliseconds. The fourth complex is ventricular extrasystol. The combination of the right bundle branch block pattern with right axis deviation belongs to bifascicular blocks too. In this case, both the right bundle branch and the posterior fascicle of the left bundle branch are blocked. However, other causes of the right axis deviation, such as right ventricular hypertrophy, lateral ST segment elevation, myocardial infarction, should be excluded. ECG shows right bundle branch block with right axis deviation. The QRS complex width is 140 milliseconds. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe.